So over here we have Matthias Shaw and Gen Greymane. Gen, who doesn't want to talk to me for some reason.
For country, for family.
I know, you're a very good boy. Sorry, Matthias.
We fight in the shadows.
I was wondering where he was during the big fight, right before the raid, and I was like, where's Matthias? Why isn't he here? Hello. This is one of those things I got mad at someone spoiled ahead of time. Because I rather would have uncovered this myself. Not really super secret, but... So Matthias is here, Beldrakken, talking again. The quest to pick up the, Return to Gilneas is right here. Next to the portal. Person that teaches you the portal. If you have a mage and you know how to find portals. So, Arlaeya, how have you... Have you kept... I can't read. Ah, Arlaeya, have you kept... Well here in Isles? It just so happens I have some information you might be interested in hearing. Stay a while and listen, of course.
You're certain it was him?
My agents and Ratchet confirmed it. He was seen buying supplies.
Why Kalimdor? Why wouldn't he return home to Stormwind?
I don't know, but he was traveling south. Must have noticed my people on his tail. He lost them in the Barrens.
South? What could he be after? Send word to Jaina. She'll want to know where he's headed.
You don't want to go after him yourself?
If he's staying away, he must have his reasons. We need to trust him.
Should I inform Lord Commander Turalyon?
No. Not until we know more. Let's keep this quiet, Spymaster.
It will be done, King Greymane.
I think we know who they're talking about. So dropping the little subtle hint over here. And right now it's... Let's just keep it between us. Right. So you would mind if I went and I told Wrathion, right? Just kidding. So, yeah, interesting. He's headed south. We've seen... the cinematic. We know where he's. Yeah. So before I know where I want to go first, and I'm not going to go there first. But at least they're not fighting. But look at here. Look at here. This is. I was saying, because many times I visited here before, I was like, come on, give Abyssian his proper due. Just sitting there looking there. Good. Erythra's upgraded. Straz is upgraded, Galagos is the same, Storm is the same. But Abyssian's got his proper aspect. Look, you're much bigger, my dude. I guess that's what happens. But Vyranoth is here. Look at Vyranoth with her little hands. Hi, Vyranoth. Look at her little hands. She's like got her them folded, like I am judging you. Aspect of storms. The view from here is giving me more ample perspective than I originally imagined. Aspect of storms. A title I chose myself for many reasons. Blessed by Azeroth, our world's primal fury now courses through me, relentless as a hailstorm, howling with frozen winds. I stand as well for the Thorinir and the Netherwing, and the storms they call home. Nice. And finally, I sought to honor my fallen sister one final time. Razageth, the Storm Eater, who gave me the gift of freedom. One that I will share with all dragonkind. Well. I love you, Vyranoth. I do. Okay, Alexstrasza does have a quest for me. I'm going to go look at everybody else. I think Murthar has nothing more to say to me. That's fine.
I stand with you.
Oh! Our troubles may be far from over, but for the first time since the primal incarnates were released, my heart is warm with the hope that we will succeed. That's the part about part of my family as well, but there is a stay a while and listen. Nosdorm was still talking about turning into Murazan. Abyssian has nothing to say to me. Do we want to talk to them? We want to talk to them, right? Let's talk to them. All right. You guys behaving? Are you boys behaving?
It seems our fates are intertwined.
Tell me about it. Ah, Arlaeya. It's good to see you. I find myself slipping in and out of daydreams as of late, reminiscing on all that has happened since our arrival in the Isles. Perhaps it is because we find ourselves in a rare moment of respite. Or maybe I am enthralled by the stunning view from atop this landing. Wrathion whispers to conceal his words from Sibelian. Or even dare I say it, thanks to the welcome sight of Abyssian standing beside the other aspects. You dare say it.
Wrathion, Abyssian mentioned that you will soon depart from the Isles.
I didn't take you as one who engaged in gossip, Sibelian.
Does he speak true?
He does. Iridikron may be lying low, but he still poses a significant threat to Azeroth. I will coordinate the Black Talon's efforts to track him down. Even Iridikron can't evade them forever.
Indeed. I must admit, your agents have impressed me far more than I expected. With rare exception, I never placed much stock in mortals beforehand. You have quite the way with their kind.
I suppose I do. My time in the Dragon Isles was a grand adventure, but not the homecoming I'd hoped for. I've often felt that I share more in common with mortals than with dragons, and feared that I belong among neither. I thought that here, in the land of my ancestors, I'd find something I was lacking, that by becoming an aspect I could prove who and what I truly am. If not to the world, then at least to myself. But I see now that I never had anything to prove. My place is among both mortals and dragons. That is my strength, not my failing. It's who I am. Who I've always been.
Well said. You walk a path I never could, Wrathion. Take pride in it. And should that path lead you back to the Dragon Isles, I hope it does feel like a homecoming.
We shall see. Thank you, brother.
I got feelings right now. Lots and lots of feelings right now. One, I was right. I knew his ass would get bored. It's like, you don't want to be aspect. You just want to be aspect so Sibelian's not aspect and because you have nothing else to do. Now you have else to do. Also, what are you going to do with all these black talons you've amassed over the years that are spying on everything? Yeah, it's coming into work. Diplomacy didn't work long, did it? But, yeah, it worked where it was needed. But yeah, so Wrathion's leaving to go find Iridikron. That's pretty great. Alright. Sorry, I'm a little like, you know, got a long history with this character. I'm happy for him. And, you know, if you need help, You know, and you have some extra stuff you want to give away. You know where to find me. Okay.
Call me.
All right. So here are we up to. Bissian won't talk to me. Sibelian won't talk to me. Nozarmu's still talking about 10.17.
How can I help?
Kelly goes, stay a while, listen. He doesn't say anything different from that he said before when he says he considers me part of his family.
Impeccable timing, champion. Khadgar should be arriving shortly.
My ears are burning, Kallik. To what do I owe the honor?
Bittersweet news, I'm afraid. Khadgar, I have chosen to step down from the Council of Six. My duties as Aspect must take precedence. I'm needed in Valdrakken far more than in Dalaran.
Is that all? Forgive me, but that hardly comes as a surprise. I suspected as much when you asked to speak with me.
So, you do not think ill of me for relinquishing my position?
Bearish the thought. Your family comes first, Kallik. I could never fault you for that. Though, I do have a request to make of you. The artifact Iridikron took from the Forbidden Reach, the one he handed over to this mysterious harbinger. Dalaran's libraries hold precious little information on it. Given Malagos's history with Neltharion...
You hope that I might have better luck scouring the Azure archives. Consider it done, old friend. I will share all the information I can find.
Thank you, Kallik. Strange, isn't it? The Kirin Tor and the aspect of magic working hand in hand.
It's a new age, one we will face together. Us, the Council, and whoever replaces me.
Rest assured, we will fill your vacant seat. But no one could ever replace you. Farewell for now, Caligos. Be it here, Dalaran, or Karazhan. I look forward to our next reunion.
There's magic in everything.
Aww. Well, I mean, again, kind of still going with the theme of finding out what, you know, Iridikron was up to and that artifact. Also making reference to the Nexus War of when we actually killed Malagos. The Council of Six. I don't know. Well, Jaina is a little busy, but you think Jaina might need another job? It's funny. I was wondering about that because I've been doing a lot of Legion content. And, you know, Kallik is there in Dalaran. He's one of the six. He soups up your weapons and stuff. Has a whole big part of a whole big quest line with Senegos in Azuna. But yeah, I was like, he's still in the Council of Six, isn't he? But he's Aspect now. What does that mean? Yeah, he's not. It makes sense. I like that he was like, I don't know how to tell you this, but like, I'm an Aspect now, so I'm not gonna have time to chill with you guys anymore. I think he's fine. Alshaz, I think, is gonna trigger the quest. Let me see what else is around here. This is very much like the end of Shadowlands, with the stay a while and listen. In several places. Which means that you could always come back here and stay a while and listen, and I like that. Do you have anything for me?
My watch continues.
And you still welcome me to Valdragon, like my dude.
Titans watch over you.
Been here nearly every day for the past year. What are you talking about? How about you?
I serve the aspects. Glory to Valdrakken.
Yeah, the little dialogue bubbles, I mean, there's not quests over them, so you can't... Let me use a regular mount. Just to make sure I don't miss anything. I don't think so. I think I got everyone that has a little bubble. A little bubble option.
This world is
yeah. Abyssian, why don't you talk to me, my dude? After all the help I gave you? Putting up with these two?
Is there something you wish to discuss?
Not yet. Yeah, that's it. Except for let's go talk to Alistraza. Which is why we get cutscene ready. The one thing I do not like about the aspects is that they're all so huge, which is great on the one hand, but on the other hand, I have to pan out so far to be able to see any of them. So Vyranoth's little hands are going to always make me chuckle. They're too cute. She doesn't have to stay a while and listen, but she's definitely worth talking to for what she says about... Basically, she's aspect of storms. A lot of people suspected that there'd be another dragon assuming that spot. Doesn't have her own banner. You need a banner, my lady. You need a banner. But it's fitting when you think of the dragons that joined. I didn't even think about the nether drakes. Yeah, nether storms. All right, let's do this.
Where there is life, there is hope.
It's been a long road for us all, Arlaeya. But after persevering through hardship and strife, dragonkind stands poised. It's been a long road for us all, Arlaeya. But after persevering through hardship and strife, dragonkind stands poised to enter a new age. Before you leave for your next adventure, my fellow Aspects and I wish to thank you for all that you have done for us. Speak with Alistraza at the Sea of the Aspects in Valdrakken. Guys, they're going to make me feel special. All right, let's do this.
Life endures. What is it you seek? My friend, we have asked you here this day to offer our thanks. When we dragons returned to our homeland, we were a kingdom divided. Old wounds and bitter memories had fractured our unity. But thanks to you, and all those who stood with us, we have found our way to a better future. We realized that the mistakes of our past need not define us. That we should not fear the unknown. That we could embrace our family while building a new legacy for our flights. A legacy that includes all dragonkind. In recognition of everything you have done, we proclaim you champion of the Dragonflights.
Champion. That explains why they've been calling me that for several weeks. Turn it in. Fair skies and strong winds. Fair skies and strong winds to you, Arlaeya.
The balance must be maintained.
Oh. Thanks to you and all the mortals who defended the Emerald Dream, a new world tree grows in the Dragon Isles. Emerdrasil's bows will be a haven for peace and tranquility, and a place of respite for the Kaldari souls lost to Tildrassil. Tyrande Whisperwind and Chandra's Feathermoon are at the tree now. They would share words with you. Meet Tyrande and Chandra's and Amidrasil. I was like, alright. Tyrande! See, Gilneans are dressing up today. What you looking at? I didn't see any of the wisps that are around here.
Shall we begin?
Welcome to Belamethoma.
Nature will heal.
The returning is a time of reflection and change, Arlaeya, for the world and for my people.
I'm your people. I'm your people.
God damn it. Alright. Had the cheese head. Anyway. The returning is a time of reflection and change, Arlaeya, for the world and my people. My mother and I have been discussing the roads that led us here, and where those roads will lead us in the years to come. Come, let us speak. Speak with Chandra's father, Feathermoon. See, from this I get two cosmic, because I get two mogs. A Violet Calderay bedroll, and a Violet Calderay backpack. Okay, let's accept. Of course I'm going to accept.
We will find the answers we seek. I am listening.
Let me turn myself off.
On your mark. Such beauty. Such tranquility. More Kaldori settle here every day. After so many years of strife, Belameth offers rest and comfort. This village welcomes all who wish to dwell here. But it shall not be our only home. Hyjal, Val'Shirah, Ashenvale. These are sacred places to us. We shall protect them forevermore. And one day, when life blossoms again upon its ashen shores, we will return to Teldrassil and build anew.
I mean, say what you want about Nabby Boy. I'm really happy for Tyrone. Also, was that the first time, like, two characters actually kissed in this game? Like, that it looked like it? And not colliding polygons? But still, like, yeah, I'm crying, what? I think so. Technology did not exist before this moment. Anyway, I'm in my feelings again. Before I claim my prize. You're not going to talk to me, Furion?
I must protect the wild.
Yeah, we're good. Shh.
The goddess gives me
I will always
strength.
Almost cry again soon. Okay. So, I gotta collect myself. It's been emotional.
Emotional roller coaster ride. I mean, it's not like it's a surprise. We knew he was coming back. And it didn't help that someone already posted a fucking spoiler on social media. The servers had just come online 15 minutes and someone posted the picture. Look who's back. I'm like, fuck you. Can I please... But the moment was not ruined. Look, I will tell you one thing. Having done Legion recently and hearing over the part of where Geronda's looking for him, it is so very much Xavius making fun of Malfurion. Like, having done that twice so close to each other, because I'm trying to get titles for everybody, I was like, oh, yeah, it really is Xavius making fun of Malfurion. And you have to ask Geronda, did you not notice? I realize you're upset right now, but can you just for a second listen? Yeah, no, I'm Team Geronda. Yeah, no, I mean, it's hilarious. Geronda! And you realize, oh, he's making fun of Malfurion. Okay, that's kind of great. You know, Geronda, she's has legit concerns at that point. It's easy to just, you know, being caught up in a moment, but I was like, but anyway, my point is his behavior during that scene cannot be blamed on him, because it's not. Because when you get to inside Darkheart Thicket, which is the dungeon that leads up to, he's like, Xavius growls at you some nonsense about, I'm tough guy, blah, blah, blah. And Malfurion's like, so says the shade of Xavius. It's like, it's very amusing. But, but anyway, enough about Legion, which I am enjoying replaying bits of again. I mean, I left so many characters halfway through that it's kind of fun to kind of move them along and get stuff like new mounts and titles. But back to this. I gotta turn this in. Ugh. These epilogues, man.
Much remains to be done. Godfather, we have so much to tell you.
As I slumbered within Ardenweald, Ysera let me dream through her eyes. I saw the courage you showed defending Emerdrasil. I am so proud of you both, and of all the heroes of Azeroth who joined together for this cause.
Though we will never forget the past, it is time to look forward. Our people will be pleased to have both of you leading them into that future. No, my beloved daughter. I think we will tarry here in Belenath a while. I believe we have earned some time alone together.
That we have, my love.
But our people they have all they need in you, child.
You have grown into a wise leader, Chandris. Within you beats the heart of the Kaldorei people. Trust your instincts. And if you have need of us, you know where we will be.
Thank you for your faith in me, for everything. Now come. I want to show you a spot that would be perfect for our home.
I do hope there is room for a garden.
Malfurion, it's a whole garden. It's all room green. Druid. But Chandris, that's another thing I've been wondering about lately. I'm like, there's this feeling of passing a torch. And I think at this point, like, Geronda and Malfurion, like, Yeah, we'll be there when you need us, but holy shit, I think we've earned a vacation. So I like that. And Chandris, I will follow her through hell and back. So